What's up everyone? Today I'll be doing an unboxing video of this new Shimano Corrado BFS reel. That's right guys, this has been a long awaited for BFS reel across the world. The leading makers of BFS reels have always been releasing only BFS reels in Asia, but Shimano finally have acknowledged that there is a market outside of Asia. So this spring, Shimano finally dropped this Corrado BFS reel in North America and Europe. You guys ready for this unboxing video? Cause I am freaking excited and ready to go. Let me break down the contents of this video for you guys. It's gonna be a relatively long one. So if you guys want, you guys can check out the description below as I have left timestamp sections of each chapter of the video. First, I will briefly explain what BFS is, and I really think that this is still a very, very young style of fishing, and in order for us to keep growing this style of fishing across the world globally, we got to educate the community. So that's gonna be the first thing on the list. Don't worry guys, I'll try to keep it short as possible. Second, I will be doing the unboxing of this reel. I'm gonna walk you through this sexy new Corrado, but quick spoiler. Yes, clicker baby. Fourth, I'll do a quick comparison to the other Shimano BFS reel that I have, the Aldebaran BFS. This is their highest end, low profile BFS reel. And lastly, I'll wrap up the video with my test plan. That's right guys, I'll be testing this reel in several ways and I wanna share with you guys what I'll be doing and I'll give you guys the opportunity to let me know what do you guys wanna see me test first. Yeah, it's gonna be a pretty long video, so let's get started. So let's first talk about BFS. BFS stands for Bait Finesse System. This is a marketing term that Shimano have created to basically categorize their super finesse bait casting reels. Now, the demand for these type of finesse reels have been pretty much off the roof in Asia. So there's a lot of brands out there that created their own version. But within the fishing community, BFS fishing community that is, everyone still calls it BFS regardless of what brand it is. So how does a BFS reel work? Let's talk about that first. So there are three common things you guys will notice when comparing a BFS reel to, let's say, a typical bait casting reel. Let's first talk about the most obvious thing, the shallow spool. There is two purposes that this shallow spool serves. The first one is that shallow spools has a larger circumference, so it will be dispensing more line per rotation. And that is key for getting some of the light lures out. And the second thing of the shallow spool is that we aren't finesse fishing. We are not throwing heavy lures, so we don't use heavy line. We use thin line. And this shallow spool actually have so much capacity on it, which we will talk a little bit later when we go over the specs, that yeah, plenty, okay? Especially if you put on braided line, yeah, plenty, all right? Plenty of line. And if you have too much line, especially if you guys have a deep spool, that is excess weight. So it's really important to have a shallow spool for BFS fishing. And this leads to the next part, because we're talking about weight now, the weight of the spool, okay? Having a lighter spool will allow you to throw lighter lures. Unlike a spinning reel, the line rotates spirals off your spool. With a bait casting reel, when you cast, it relies on the weight of the lure to pull line out when you do your initial cast. So if you have a heavy spool and a light lure, you guys probably have done this before, casting, you know, super light lure on a normal bait caster. If you do an overhead cast, your lure would fly short, right in your face, right down right in front of you. Or if you're doing a side cast, roll cast, if you guys use your right hand, it's gonna go to like the far left. So yep, if you guys ever run into that, that just means your spool is just too heavy for the lure you're throwing. Lastly, you guys don't see it right here, but inside this reel here, it has micro bearings. Micro bearings is really important, especially for lighter lures. Let me give you guys a quick analogy, okay? Let's take a look at cars. You guys know how transmission work? It basically goes with smaller gears, all right, to bigger gears, because it's actually easier to roll that smaller gears going than a bigger one. Another analogy would be, let's just say, a tennis ball versus a basketball. Which one's easier to start? So it's really important to have micro bearings in your BFS reels because it allows it to rotate easier. The initial start is the most important to getting that lure to fly out. And I'll show you guys these micro bearings later because these are truly small bearings. So there's a lot of people that have asked me this question, and that is, why would I use a bait casting reel, a BFS reel, to cast light lures when I could use a spinning reel and cast light lures? And I could typically cast light lures further with a spinning reel than a bait casting reel. Although that is a true statement, I feel that bait casting reels are getting a lot better, especially in the BFS realm. They cast lighter lures and they can start casting them even further. But there's actually a golden set of answers that I give to these people. You guys ready for this? The first thing is accuracy. There is no secret that a bait casting reel is a lot more accurate than a spinning reel. And for those who don't know, let me tell you the reasons why. First and foremost, when you guys cast with a bait casting reel, you guys could easily stop or slow down the lure trajectory by using your thumb. You could slowly feather it, you could put a stop on it right away, and it's so easy. All it is on or off or softly on, all right? Very, very easy. Can you do that with a spinning reel? You guys probably can stop it, but there are actually a bigger issue, and that is how you would hold the line. Everyone hold a line differently, and typically every time you hold a line, it could be different. All right, so for a spinning reel, you are using your finger, typically your index finger, right? Some people may use a middle finger, some may use two fingers, I don't know, all right? But a finger has fingerprints. It could be dry, it could be wet, you could be cold, it could be hot, you know, so it could be hard or soft. You could have clothing, all right? So it's never always 100% the same way. And back to stopping a lure from flying out, how would you do that with a spinning reel? Sure, you could close the bail, right? It's almost, it's just as simple as just smashing your finger right here onto the spool, right? But that will give it a instant stop. It could splash like a crazy, not stealthy entry of your lure, right? So as I mentioned earlier, bait casting reel, you could feather this. Can you really do that with a spinning reel? You actually can. It's a very, very advanced technique. You actually put your finger where the line actually oscillates off because it spirals off, right? But you can't really control it that much. You can't. You know, you could feather it, and that's pretty much it. You put your hand too much in, what's happened is it's gonna stop the line and it's gonna fall. But yeah, it's a very high level technique and not many people actually do it. Reason number two, efficiency. I want you guys to take a moment and actually write this down, okay? So take a bait casting reel, okay? And think about all the steps you guys actually need to do to cast a lure. Then do the same thing, write it down for spinning reel. What you guys will realize very quickly is that a bait casting reel is a lot more efficient as it takes a lot less steps than a spinning reel. So what does that actually mean? Well, if you take a lot less steps to retrieve, and do your next cast, if you have an 8-hour day, which one will allow you guys to cast more, which means you get to cover more water? Obviously the bait casting reel. The next thing is lightweight. Your typical bait casting reel is a lot lighter than your spinning reel. So you definitely want to use a bait casting reel if you guys have a long fishing trip, especially if you guys are tournament anglers, right? It's really important that you guys don't increase your fatigue quick because then you lose your competitive advantage. And then for folks like me who have like body pains, you don't want to throw heavy stuff, right? Well, you guys should check out BFS reels because they could be really, really light. There are actually some out there that's lighter than this Corrado BFS reel, but we can talk about that a little later when we talk about the Aldebaran BFS reel. Last one is line management. Now, when you guys throw light lures on a spinning reel, when there's not enough tension on the line on a spinning reel, it will cause line twists, okay? And if you guys are not good at casting spinning reels, meaning you guys don't close your bail manually and, you know, put the line back onto the roller, well, that one extra spin around before it automatically take the line and shove it back onto the roller, that actually caused line twists. So yeah, guys, this reel here, bait casting reels, don't create line twists unless the lure actually create line twists, okay? So less line twists means more time fishing. Obviously with bait casting reels, there is chances of backlashing if you are not tuning your reel properly. So make sure you guys listen carefully later when I talk about this reel, about specs, because I will include on how you could tune a BFS reel. So those are all the benefits that I have found a bait casting reel, a BFS bait casting reel over a spinning reel. For those BFS enthusiasts out there, if you guys believe that I have missed anything, feel free to leave it a comment below as we are trying to educate the fishing community and grow the sport. And I want to thank you guys in advance for doing so. Well guys, the intro is officially over. It's time for us to go through the specs. You guys ready for this?
All right, folks, it is time for the unboxing portion of the video. Let's first assess the box and see what it says. It's always good to take a look at the box and see what they say because they always have something on here. But I'm doing a quick glance on here and I realized that they don't have all the specs that the website has. So let me go through some of these first and then we'll talk about some of the stuff that's stated on the website. So this thing right here is 8.5 2-to-1 gear ratio. That is really, really fast. This thing actually, and if you look at the end right here, it says it goes 32 inch per turn. So it will be reeling in very, very fast, which is not too bad. You could always slow it down, but it's really, really tough to speed it up. This thing has 8 pounds of drag, which is plenty enough, especially for finesse fishing. And one thing it doesn't say on the box is that this has a drag clicker. Yes, there is a clicker. So can't wait to test that out and see how it sounds like. This thing weighs 6.2 ounces. You could say it's not the lightest BFS reel out there. This thing sports the Shimano Hagane, which means metal. Sounds like Full Metal Alchemist. Hagane no Renkin Jutsushi. Yes, Jimbo is a weeaboo. I love anime and I do love Full Metal Alchemist. So each time I see Shimano products and say Hagane, I kind of, you know, just reminisce all those awesome anime episodes. But anyway, let's keep moving on. 7+1 ball bearings right there. Okay, and I got to show you guys their ball bearings. It's freaking sick, especially for BFS reels. I mentioned earlier, it's really, really important to have micro bearings. You guys should check out these bearings that comes on this reel. And the last thing we could talk about on this box is line capacity. So it's interesting how they wrote it here. They didn't really write any line diameters. And I looked at the website, they did the same thing, but we are making an assumption that they are using US diameters. So if you look at the capacity here, let's look at PowerPro for a second. 15-pound PowerPro braided line. It's approximately 4-pound US mono line, so that's more of a 6-pound mono, okay? And it could put 45 yards, which is a lot. So imagine yourself, if you guys are using this for a super finesse reel, you put 4-pound mono or even 2-pound mono, you could put a lot more than 45 yards. But, you know, most of the people who does BFS fishing, it's gonna be probably around 10 to 15 pounds braided line. So you have way enough line, especially when you guys throwing light lures. So a lot of line here. Anyway, let's move on to the actual unboxing. I got the knife, all right. Boom, the official cut right there, guys. The official cut. All right, let's take a look what's in this box. All right, so we have the schematics, which is really, really important. And what the heck is this? Not be a, all right, this is a piece of plastic. I thought it was someone freaking pube in the box. But yep, just plastic. All right, let's see, schematics. We don't need to look at all of them, but I do want to see something. Perfect, perfect. It's really important that you guys have this paper, because if you guys don't have the instructions here, obviously you guys have to reference it online, but I always keep my schematics and all my information in my box, and I keep the box, so this is gonna be perfect, but I'll come back to this later. So you have your instructions, you have your schematics, right? Let's throw that over there, somewhere else, far away. Let's take a look what's in the box. Right, we see the reel there, laying right there, but they also gave us some oil. Look at that. You got some bantam oil, okay? So it's 6 grams of oil. Look at that. Okay, so let's take this out. And we have another bottle of oil. Look at that, there's two oils. One is more thicker, one is thinner. But typically, guys, I use the thinner one for the reel bearings, so the spool and the side plate, and then I use the thicker one for outside bearings, like the reel handles, okay? So that's cool, they came with some oil, that's really, really nice. I think, you know, they say you get what you pay for, and Japanese products, man, they take good care of you. Look at that, two freaking oils. All right, so let me open this up right here. So here we are, guys, the unbox Corrado BFS reel, the long-awaited for BFS reel from Shimano. All right, it actually looks pretty good. Looks just like, I would say, the Scorpion BFS with some minor stuff. By the way, if you guys are not familiar, Japan releases a higher-end Corrado in Asia, and that's the Scorpion lineup. But take a look at that, it looks really similar in shape. And here we go, we gotta do the drag clicker sound. Ready? So I have this thing on, what, loose? Here we go, listen to this. All right, put it right next to the mic. Sounds very beautiful, yeah? All right, so they all also have a clicker with the drag star right there. Okay, so that's nice. Check out the tension knob. All right, tension knob does not have a clicker, so it stays quiet. It's not like we need a clicker anyway for these reels, but I do still like it because you can do micro fine-tuning adjustments if you need it. All right, but most of the time I don't fish with tension on the spool anyway. So only some reels that I have to for specific type of casting, or if I do skipping, then I do increase the tension. But generally for BFS fishing, we fish with no tension, meaning that we'll put this tension knob loose as possible, but you don't want this. You hear this? Let me put this next to the mic. That's a side-to-side movement, okay? So for your y'all newbies, if you guys want to cast the furthest for roll cast, side cast, overhead cast, not skipping, okay? What you guys would want to do is just tighten this knob to a point where there is no side-to-side play. And that's how you first configure your reel. You put your brakes up, you know, high as possible. Let's say, you know, 80% and practice casting, and then eventually you can lower down the brakes. All right, so this reel do look kind of like the Aldebaran too. So I will showcase the Aldebaran in a second because I have it over there, okay? We have aluminum handle right there. Nice, soft, grippy handles here. It actually feels really good, just like the Aldebaran. That's nice, very nice. One thing I noticed is the spool is not super ported like the Aldebaran, which once again, you guys will see, but we'll just keep moving on. All right, cool. There you go, the logo for the Hagane, okay? So they have the frame all metal, but the outside here, it's priced graphite or carbon. I think it's graphite. Here's the braking controls on the side. Oh, geez, this is actually very, very hard to turn. All right, very, very hard to turn. That's interesting. But FTB, Finesse Tune Braking System, okay? Brake system. For those who are not familiar with the FTB braking system, this is what makes the Shimano BFS reels very, very awesome, okay? And let me open up and I'll tell you guys. If you guys are familiar with some of their other reels, they typically have a centrifugal braking system, which is their brakes is basically built onto the spool and the side plate. It works together, right? But most of the components are on the spool itself. And then you have the digital braking system. So that's also built into the spool. So for these light application where you have cast light lures, you gotta have a light spool. So they basically move the braking system off the spool completely, okay? And they have it as a magnetic braking system. And it's not your typical magnetic braking system, okay? It is, come on. It is a lot different. Let me show you guys this right here. See this right here? Yes, your typical ones you would see is your magnets are laying right on a plate right here. And it will go to a spool, right? And there's a huge wall here. And the closer it gets to the spool, then the more braking it applies. Well, this one, the FTP braking system, it's, I guess the best way to say it is like a hybrid of centrifugal braking system plus magnetic. However, there is no touching, okay? And how it works out, I'll show you guys in a second. But the FTP braking system is actually cool. There's three things about this that's so awesome. I think the first part I already mentioned, they migrated all the stuff off the spool as much as possible onto the side plate so that it reduces weight, okay? This thing will go in and out, okay? As you increase or decrease the braking mechanism, it'll go into here, okay? Into the spool this way. The faster your spool spins, this thing actually pops out. There's actually a spring here, and I guess I could take a... Here, I'll take this knife right here. Oh, you guys see that? I guess the better angle would be right here. See that? It actually pops out just a little bit. So yeah, the faster this thing spins, this thing pops out just a little bit more. And if you have magnets closer to the spool, the stronger the magnet braking system will work. So if you cast too hard, spinning too fast, you throw a lure that's way too heavy and it just goes so fast, it's gonna pop out sooner rather than later. So that's pretty cool. And the last thing is, you guys see this guy right here, the N, okay? The N here and the N here. These are actually removable. Removable. So if you guys want weaker breaks, especially when you guys throw in specific lures, right? And you guys want more micromanagement, less breaks is actually more, okay? So you guys could simply remove that and put it somewhere else, like back into your box. And always remember, the N is up, okay? N is up. And that's why I mentioned earlier that it's important to have your paper with you, okay? In case you guys forget. So yeah, three things, very, very cool, eh? And let me show you guys very quick. It's probably hard to see, but there is a bearing in there. So if you guys ever need to replace the bearing or you guys need to clean it, Well, good luck getting it. But yep, it does have a super small micro bearing. So let me just check the spool right out here so you guys can, wait, what? Huh, there's no bearing here. Yeah, oops. So where's the bearing? Okay, so it's a bearing's not here, so it gotta be on the side here. That's interesting. That is super interesting. So I don't know how many bearings they have total, but two is typically, that's all you need for BFS fishing. All right. Okay, so it's right here. Take a look at that. Very small. Is it gonna focus? I am looking in. I can't tell if there's another, I don't see another bearing. But yeah, it looks like here to me, you cannot remove this bearing without taking out the entire reel. So, ouch. That's all I have to say is ouch. But yeah, those bearings are super small. I will show you guys on the outer bearing since it's actually easy to look at a little later. The website have stated that this reel does sport their super free spool and X-Ship features. Without going into too much details, technical details, that basically just say that this reel here will have less friction on free spooling, which is really, really important when you're casting light lures. You want it free as possible, okay? And also it's very durable. So I pretty much went through the specs. Let me just weigh the spool. I'm actually very interested because this spool right here doesn't have the bearing on it. That actually could be a very, very nice thing for aftermarket spool companies because now you don't need to supply a bearing. That's pretty nice. But anyway, let's put this on here. And of course we don't use that, we use grams. So 9.1, and lift it back up. 9.1. So I believe the Scorpion BFS reel without the bearing, because the Scorpion actually has the bearing on here, that without the bearing is 8.9. So it's very, very similar. Don't have it side by side, but I think, and I just say I think the Scorpion spool might be just a tad bit thicker, right? And that's why they had more slots drilled into it. But 9 grams is not too bad. I think this reel might be typically your bass fishing BFS reels. For those who want to throw light lures, I don't know if you could throw 1 gram, but Jimbo will try. But likely there'll be aftermarket spools available soon that allows enthusiasts who wants to throw extreme ultralight lures at the 1 gram or sub 1 gram level for this reel. So that'd be exciting. I think I'll probably get one or two of those whenever those drops. I don't know who's gonna be first dropping one, but I heard that the spool for Scorpion BFS actually fits this reel, but again, it does have bearings on it. So yeah, that's very interesting. I need to talk to folks, or you know, again, you guys can probably watch the reel test or Hobie Wan Kenobi. They could probably confirm it very, very quick whether the spool actually fits and it actually works. So interesting. And so I am bringing out the Aldebaran BFS XG 2016. And yeah, I'm gonna do a quick reel comparison for you guys. As you guys see, the size is just about the same, okay? I'll give you guys a side profile view. Now, this is what I'm talking about here. You guys see that guide right there to the right? Let me rotate it this way. You can see that it's a crazy looking cone port. I guess I gotta hold it this way. Give it some more light. There we go. All right, here we go. All right, see that right there? The line guide is actually a big fat cone there. It's like kind of like an oval cone, okay? And then on the other side, it goes narrow into a circle. And the Corrado BFS reel actually don't have that. Okay, just straight up circle. Circle on both sides, about the same diameter, okay? That's a concern for me because that thing right here, on the Aldebaran BFS reel, that thing helped reduce a lot of friction when you guys casting, okay? And when we throw light lures, any friction will reduce casting distance and potential even accuracy. So yeah, that's very interesting. I may end up keeping this reel as a bass or you know even power BFS fishing, but we shall see after our cast testing video. Word on the street says that this spool does not fit, but only one way to find out, right? So let me take this out. All right, let's take a look at them together. Yeah, this spool does look a little different. All right. So here go the two spools together. You guys can take a look. As you can see, the Aldebaran is a lot more ported.
and it's a lot more lighter. And you do see that micro bearing that I was talking about earlier, right there. It's freaking small, very, very small. All right. With the bearing, you can see that this thing is actually super light. Look at that, 7.8 with the freaking bearing, that's so small. Okay, if I take this off, it's probably what, maybe 7.2, 7.1. Very, very light spool. So this guy right here, the outer bearing, is way more versatile than this guy here, the Corrado. Oh, wait a sec, Jimbo wants to test. So the moment of truth, will this fit into here? Hey, that fits. But it looks like it might have a little gap. Hold up, let me take this guy back out. This guy, okay, let's do it one more time. Yeah, there, it looks like there's a gap in there. And I don't know if they're the same length spools, so I don't want to close it on them. Yeah, it looks like the spool length is actually a little different too, so I definitely don't want to close it up. And if I actually align the two spools together, it looks like the outer bearing is a little bit more narrow. So here's a quick comparison of the side plate and the braking mechanism. They both do sport the FTP braking system, but as you can see, the color is a little different. And I also noticed that the braking system, right, they are aligned a little different compared to each other. But that shouldn't change anything, I don't think. It looks the same, how shape and everything. So, yep, it's probably just cosmetics. Okay, so let's put this thing back. All right, so let's put this back together and let me weigh the entire wheel one more time for you guys to see. Everyone likes to see comparison side by side, not, you know, sorting all over the place. So let's put this on ounces. This is what, 6.1? 6.21, okay. 6.21, all right. And this guy should be 4 point something. There you go, look at that, 4.6. 4.6 it is, yep, super duper light. Let me take a look at the rear handles for a second. The rear handle size is the same, but you see that this handle here for the Corrado is a lot thicker, so I could likely reduce some weight on the handle portion if I really, really need to reduce the weight. But yeah, that's interesting, man. This whole body right here, so much lighter than this guy here. But the real size is just about the same thing. It feels okay, right? Yep, feel just about the same. But you guys can feel this, noticeably a lot heavier than this guy right here. So perhaps one of the things I may do in the future is a weight reduction for this reel if it's that good, all right? Just a quick reminder, if you guys want to see other reels from Shimano compared to the Corrado, make sure you guys check out the Reel Test and also Hobie One Kenobi. They have basically all the Shimano BFS reels, all right? So definitely want to check them out. So what do you guys think about this reel so far? I really think that this is their entry level reel now. It's great that they have released this reel globally, because it's actually in Asia as well. I saw this sold all over AliExpress recently, so which is pretty insane. And then I actually saw it on eBay too, so I don't know where they got those. But yeah, I think there is potential in the bass fishing realm, but I'm not quite sure yet. I probably would keep this at the bass fishing realm or power BFS, but I am looking forward to aftermarket spools so I could play around with lighter lures. But in the meantime, I'm gonna definitely keep this thing stock so I could do some testing. Some of the testing that I'll be doing is ultralight bait finesse. So, you know, I'm gonna put very light thin line on and see how light this thing could go. Can it do the 1 gram? Not quite sure, but I know the Scorpion can do it very short distance, but I am wondering if this can handle it. If it can't, it's fine. Like I said, I'll probably use this for other fishing, but I am looking forward to testing some aftermarket spools whenever it pops out. But likely I'll be using this as a bass BFS reel. So that's gonna be my second test. I'll be fishing with light Ned rigs, Jika rigs, light lures, light top water lures. Basically what this reel has been designed for. And then lastly, I'll probably do power BFS fishing, which I use some thicker line, cast some lures short range for snakeheads. Snakeheads
I got a ton around my area, the northern snakeheads. They get pretty huge. And they have a very, very strong bite force. So I can't really use ultralight to set the hook on certain lures. Given that we are in fishing in swamps, I got to go totally weedless. So I think I'm going to throw it on a medium light rod and maybe like, I don't know, 15 pound test line. And, you know, wish me luck trying to catch a 10 pounder, a snakehead. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, those are my three testing plans right now. So I'm going to use one ultralight rod, one light rod, and one medium light rod. So which one you guys want to see first? Huh? Let me know, because the weekend is coming very soon and I'm going to pick one of them during the weekend and we're going to go out and have some fun. But anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this unboxing video. I am super excited. I remember when I first started my BFS adventures several years ago, and I was like, man, it's so tough getting some BFS reels, like the Japanese BFS reels, because they're so expensive. They don't sell it here. For the popular ones and the new ones, people buy it up and they sell it on freaking eBay. So expensive. Like, I was lucky I was able to get the Daiwa Alpha's Air TW. I guess maybe 6 months after it was released, and I got it from Japan Lure Shop, and I got it at a good price. I got it basically, you know, MSRP plus shipping out of country, et cetera, et cetera. And that totaled me around $320. But I have seen that reel sold for $500, $550 on eBay. So as you see, it could get really, really expensive. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna start off my BFS adventures testing out AliExpress reels, because at that time, there were so many Chinese brands out there just releasing BFS reels, because BFS was freaking blowing up in Asia. Unfortunately, a lot of those Chinese reels were not good. There were some good budget reels at that time, but it was more of a hit or miss. So during my ventures, I was like, you know what? Why don't we get a company who could create a reel? And I went to Casking. I wrote them a 6-page paper and they came back to me with a prototype that following summer. So like 8 months later, they gave me a prototype. I played around with it. I reviewed it. I asked the community about it, you know, and they gave all the feedback back to Casking. And then last year, 2020 spring, they released the Casking Zephyr BFS reel in Asia again. And at that time, there was a lot of good budget BFS reel entry level at that time. And I was like, look, Casking, if you bring this reel to America, I bet you a lot of people will want the Zephyr. And then I told all my viewers, I was like, yo, if Casking finally release a BFS reel in America, or heck, it doesn't matter if it's Casking or not, it could be anyone. The next company that released a BFS reel, Shimano or Daiwa is going to jump right on top, because they're going to finally realize that there is a market globally and especially in North America. And guess what, guys? Here we are. Casking released the Zephyr in fall of 2020, and then in the early year of 2021, during Shimano's 100th anniversary in March, they have announced that they will drop this reel here in North America and Europe. So basically, now BFS is officially global. That is exciting. And guys, I want to thank you guys for following me on my adventures on growing the BFS niche, the fishing style that I love so much. I thank you guys for helping to grow this sport. BFS going global, it's just gonna kick off a chain of more reels coming to America, and also rods too. Don't forget rods, because they don't have any rods right now. You know, where can you get rods? Not many places, not many places. But anyway, guys, I'm done rambling. I'm so stoked. I'm so excited. And once again, I want to thank you guys all for watching this video. Make sure you guys get out there, because the fish don't wait. I got this at Discount Tackle, so I left a link in the description below. They're sold out at the moment, but they will have it ASAP, as that is what they have told me. But anyway, guys, I can't wait to do cast testing videos, so stay tuned. Peace out.